Hello, today we are going to be reviewing linear equations. I'm hoping this is a review for most of us. So I'm going to go fairly quickly through what I believe to be review. This video will be available for you, so you can always go back and reference it. And of course, when I come back, feel free to ask me any questions. We're going to be looking at linear equations, three different types of linear equations for the next 2 days. Today and then the next time I see you in class. So first of all, let's define linear equation. What is a linear equation? Well, a linear equation is an equation between two variables that gives a straight line when plotted. Since I don't have a whole lot of room to write on my screen, I am just going to write the basics. This is a straight line. Right, so a linear equation is a straight line. Now, we have three different types of linear equations we're going to look at. The first type that we have is what we call standard form. Standard form is actually one we don't typically use all the time. It's not the one we first think of, but it is a great form for several different purposes. Standard form is the equation AX plus BY equals C. That's standard form. Hopefully, all of us know slope-intercept form, like the back of our hand. Slope-intercept form is the equation Y equals MX plus B. Now, why is this called slope-intercept form? Well, hopefully we know that the M value stands for our slope, and the B value stands for our y-intercept. Mathematicians, not the most creative people. So slope-intercept is named because in the equation we can see the slope and the y-intercept. Okay, well, we have one third type that we're actually going to focus more on tomorrow, but I'm going to give it to you now. This is my favorite. As you move on in math classes, point-slope form will become your favorite as well. It's much easier for most things to leave your answer in point slope form. And point slope form looks like this. It is the equation y minus the y value. And I'm going to put a little subscript 1 so that you understand. Oops, now that looks like an 11. Subscript 1 so you understand that this is not the same y as we wrote down before, equals m times x minus x with a subscript of 1. Okay. As I said, mathematicians, not the most creative people. And this m stands for the same m we had before. This is my slope. And then the point. We have a point in here, an ordered pair, and our point is the equation, or is the values x1 and y1. So we have a slope and we have a point, point slope form. See, not very creative. Okay, well, if you notice in the two forms at the end, both of them talk about slope. So what is slope? Well, the definition of slope is the measure of the steepness of the line. So let's see if I can write all this in here. Measure of the steepness of a line. So the slope, as we know, tells us how fast our line goes up or how fast it goes down. And because it's a linear equation, it is a straight line, and the slope remains the same for the whole line. Okay, well, there are three different ways that we can find slope. So the first one is using the graph. If we are looking at a picture of a graph, and we'll go do an example in just a moment, we know that the slope is represented by the rise over the run. Okay, it's important to note that rise represents what happens as you go up and down, and run is what happens as you go to the right. We read math the same way we read English, left to right. Okay, so rise over run. Now, when we talk about going up and down, we're looking at the y values. That's where the graph is. It goes up and down. So when we look at a table, the way we can find slope on the table is we can do the change, and that's what delta means. I'll just write change in here. The change in y divided by, oops, that doesn't look very good, change in x. So we can find slope using a table of values by comparing the change in the y to the change in the x. It's just like the graph, rise over run. We're looking at the y values over the x values. Now, most of you are probably pretty familiar with the next type of slope. It's the one we use the most, and it would be slope of 2 points. Okay, so if we look at an equation for the slope of 2 points, we would do y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. Hopefully that looks very familiar to you. So change in y, change means subtraction. So the subtraction of two y's, the little subscripts on the y's don't really matter. It's just a different way to name y. It's why we started with function notation, so we can give functions different names besides y. So y2 minus y1 is just a way to differentiate between the two y values. All right, we're going to go to the next slide, and we are going to look at some examples using slope. And again, hopefully most of this is review. So the first thing we're going to look at is a graph. I want to be able to find the slope from a graph. So when we look at slope from a graph, remember we said slope was the change in the y value, rise over run. So we're going to look at the rise. Rise is what happens as we go up and down. Now remember, we read from left to right. So start at your leftmost point. Your leftmost point is the point that is, oopsies, right here. So if we look at our left point, this is our leftmost point. This is the point we want to start with on our graph. Okay, so if I count my slope, I am going to count the rise over the run. So I'm going to go up 1, 2, 3. So my slope, I know the rise part of my slope is 3 over something. Now I need to look at the run part. The run is what happens as we go from left to right. So I need to go over 1, 2 spaces. So my slope is 3/2. Okay, moving on. The next thing we want to look at is be able to calculate slope using 2 points. Remember, we need to have names for my 2 points. So I'm going to call this ordered pair the ordered pair x1 and y1, and we'll call this ordered pair x2 and y2. So x1 represents the first x value. There's no other reason I gave it that name. And then the y has to correspond. So the y1 goes with the x1. Okay, there's just the name. So now let's calculate slope. Change in y over change in x. y2 minus y1. So we do 5 minus 0 over 1 minus negative 2. So we get a slope of 5/3. So my slope in this example would be up 5/3. Rise over run, 5/3. Moving on. The next example we want to look at is we want to look at what happens when maybe there isn't a rise or a run. Very specific cases in this example, we have a horizontal line. So let's talk about the rise over the run. To go from left to right, remember we want to start at my leftmost point. So I want to start right here, and I want to figure out how much it takes to get over here. Well, am I going up any? No, I'm not going up any. So when we look at my rise, the amount I am rising is 0. And the amount that I am running over in this case is I'm going over 10. So I have rise over run equals 0 over 10. What is 0 divided by 10? It is 0. 0. What is the difference between a slope of 0 and a slope of undefined? Undefined, we divide by 0. 0 would be in the denominator. We'll look at some examples probably tomorrow or the next time I see you. Okay, and finally, we want to be able to find slope from a table, and we want to be able to interpret what it means. It does us no good if all we know is how to find the numbers, if we can't make sense of them when it comes time for word problems. I know, everybody's favorite, word problems. So let's look at how we can find slope from a table, first of all, and then how we can interpret its meaning. Okay. So I have this table sitting here where it talks about on the left-hand side the number of computer games and the right-hand side the total cost. Well, typically when I have a table of values, my input or my control is going to be on this left-hand side. These will typically be my X values. And then this would be my output or my Y values. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to look at the change in the two values, meaning what does it take to get from one to the other? So if I start with this first one and I look at the change, how much does it take to go up to get from 78 to 156? Okay, well, I know that that means I'm going up 78. Does that number hold true when I go from 156 to 234? It doesn't really matter. What we need to look at is what happens after that. And yes, we can see that this is also plus 78. So when we talk about the change in the Y, my change in Y is positive 78, and now I need to look at my change in my X's. So what is happening as I go up here? Am I going up by 1? Well, in this case, I'm going up by 2. And same thing from 4 to 6. I am also going up by 2. So therefore, my change in my Y is 2. Simplifying this, we get 39. Okay, well, the key to this problem is it said, and interpret its meaning. What does it mean that the slope in this case is 39? Well, remember, we're comparing Y to X. So my Y value was cost, and my X value was the number of games. So I'm comparing the cost per game. So my cost per game is $39. So we would say, if we're going to interpret its meaning, we would say the cost per game is $39. Great. There are some examples of finding slope. Obviously, feel free to pause this, rewind as much as you need to. Hopefully, again, that this is somewhat of a review. Now, I want to take you to one of the best videos you will ever see in math and help you remember a little bit about slopes. Okay, here we go. Ready for it?
Welcome to the Adventures of Slope Dude. Meet Slope Dude. He loves to ski. We are going to follow him, and he'll teach us some important aspects of slope. This is the course he's skiing today. What he says will teach us about slope. Always remember that Slope Dude always skis toward the right or eastward. When he starts out, he's going uphill. It's hard work. He says, puff, puff, positive, as he goes up the mountainside. Puff, puff, positive. Puff, puff, positive. Now he's at the top. It was puff, puff, positive all the way up the mountain, but now he can look forward to the downhill. On the way down the mountain, He says, nice, negative, nice, negative, nice, negative. And now, after the downhill, he's in for the hardest part of the ski route, the long flat part. He says, this is zero fun. This is zero fun. This is zero fun. As he finishes the flat part, he doesn't see well ahead, and all of a sudden he comes to the edge of a cliff. It's straight down. He finds a slope that's straight down, and so frightened is he that he says the worst curse word possible in math and in algebra. Undefined! This has been the adventure of Slope Dude. Remember always what he said during his ski trip. Up the hill or up the slope, he said, puff, puff, positive. On his downhill run, he said, nice, negative. On the long, flat part of the course, he said, this is zero fun. And finally, when he went over the vertical cliff and straight down, he yelled the worst curse word of math and algebra. Undefined! The uphill is a slope with a positive number, the downhill is a slope with a negative number, the flat part is a slope of zero, and the straight up and down or vertical part is undefined. This has been the Adventures of Slope Dude. Special thanks to Kim Yui for inventing Slope Dude. Thanks for viewing.
Now I know you are all thrilled to have seen that, and if you ever want to see it again, I will make sure it is posted on my website just for you. Okay, so we are going to move on now and look at some other examples. So let's flip the worksheet or the note sheet over. All right, so now we are going to look at writing equations of the line, and the key is that it is going to be in slope-intercept form for right now, which means we want to write the equation of the line that is in the form of y equals mx plus b. Again, I don't know that I think slope-intercept form is always the best choice, so we'll look at examples next time I see you as to when I think it is and when it is not. So let's start with the most basic one. So the first one says we are going to write an equation of the line in slope-intercept form with a slope of 1/5 and a y-intercept of 0, negative 3. Okay, what information needs to be in slope-intercept form? We need the slope, and we need the y-intercept. And guess what? This equation has both already there. So this is probably the easiest equation to be able to write. Hopefully we feel pretty good that I'm going to make this substitution in for the m for the slope to be 1/5 x plus my y-intercept. And it tells me why y-intercept is an ordered pair 0, negative 3. Well, what does that mean? What is the y value that I want to use in this equation? It's negative 3. Now, you probably won't see the equation written this way. You will probably see it written just as y equals 1/5 x minus 3. Either is correct. But again, that should be the easiest one of all of our equations. Okay, well, let's move on to one that's a little bit more challenging. I want to write the equation of the line that goes through the point 2, negative 1 and has a slope of 5. Okay, so let's fill in what we know. We know that we have y equals 5 x plus b. Okay. So y equals 5x plus b. The problem is I don't know what b is because I don't have my y-intercept. I have a different point. Well, when we look at a point, an ordered pair, the first number in that ordered pair should represent an x, and the second number should represent our y, which means we have an ordered pair xy, which I'm going to use to substitute in x and in y. So here's how this looks. I'm going to take the y value, negative 1 equals 5 times x. Well, my x value is positive 2 plus b. Now I have a chance to solve for the y-intercept that I didn't know already, or it wasn't given to me. So let's do some math. So we have negative 1 equals 10 plus b minus my 10. So we get negative 11 equals b. So now I'm able to go back in and write this b value back into my equation that we had before. So my equation in slope-intercept form would be the equation y equals 5x minus 11. Okay, well, let's look at the next one. Here would be an example of an equation that happens to be in standard form. So we have the equation 5x minus 4y equals 16. This is standard form, ax plus by equals c. Okay, so what do we want to do if we want to put this into standard form? We need to solve for the y value. So my job is to get the y value by itself. So the first thing that I'm going to do is I am going to subtract the 5x from both sides. Now, it is not wrong to write it as 16 minus 5x. That's not wrong. It may not be the best way to write it, and we'll look at why, but it's not wrong. Better, however, might be to write negative 4y equals negative 5x plus 16. This one just fits the pattern of y equals mx plus b a little bit better, but both are correct, and we'll look at why. All right. Please make sure that when you're doing these problems that the negative gets carried down with the 4y. Otherwise, you're going to end up with terms that are positive when they should be negative and vice versa. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to divide everything by negative 4. And I find when I am trying to write an equation in point slope-intercept form that I want to divide each term separately, so that it looks more like the y equals mx plus b form. Okay, so now when I divide both of these, I'm going to get y equals negative 4 plus 5 fourths x. Great. Again, not quite in the right form, so let's look at what happens here in the red. I'm going to divide by negative 4 on both sides to every term, and I get positive y equals positive 5 fourths x minus 4. Do you see how these are the same equations? Do you see how we have a negative 4 here and a negative 4 here? And that this is a positive 5 fourths and this is a positive 5 fourths? Because those are the same, we know those equations are the same. That's why I prefer this method, just because we're getting it to look like a y equals mx plus b form, slope-intercept form. This is not wrong as long as you're comfortable with understanding which one is your slope and which one is your y-intercept. Okay, well, now comes the fun part. Now we get to remind ourselves how to graph in slope-intercept form. So remember, with slope-intercept form, the first thing we do is we start with, let's choose my pencil here. The first thing that we want to do is we want to start with my y-intercept. So we always want to identify what our y-intercept is. In y equals mx plus b form, or in point slope form, slope-intercept form, I want to find my y-intercept. Well, what is my y-intercept in this first problem when I don't have anything added to it? That's right, the y-intercept would need to be 0. So this equation really says y equals 2x plus 0. So when I put a dot, I'm going to start my dot right at 0. This is hard for me to graph this, so bear with me if this doesn't quite work out. And then I'm going to count my slope. So I'm going to count my slope, and my slope says 2, which as a fraction is 2 over 1. So I'm going to go up 2 over 1, up 2 over 1, up 2 over 1, and I could go down 2 over 1 in the other direction if I'd like, just so I can get a full straight line. And then we're going to graph a straight line. Hard to do on my iPad, but you get the idea. Okay, let's try another one. Let's try the equation y equals negative 1/3 x plus 5. So I'm going to start my graph at positive 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm going to put a dot. And this time the slope is negative 1/3. So I am going to go down 1 over to the right 3. Always to the right. Even if I'm going down, even if that number is negative. So down 1, 1, 2, 3. Put a dot. Down 1 over 1, 2, 3, put a dot. And again, I could go in either direction as long as from left to right, this graph is going down 1 over 3. Okay, so finally, we have this equation over here. I'm going to rewrite it just so I have room to work. That must not be the right color. So I've got negative 2x plus 5y equals negative 10. And I need to get this into slope-intercept form. So I need to solve for the y value just like we did on the front page. Or, yes, the front page. So the first thing I want to do is I want to move my 2x over. So I am going to add 2x to both sides. So we get 5y equals, and again, I'm going to put my x in the front. So we get positive 2x minus 10. And then I'm going to divide both sides by 5, or divide everything by 5. So we get y equals 2/5 x minus 2. Now I have a y-intercept of negative 2 and a slope of 2/5. Now I can graph that. Okay, so we're going to graph it. We're going to start at negative 2, so down 1, 2. And I'm going to put a dot. Nope. It's getting worse. And then I'm going to count my slope of 2/5. I'm going to count up 2 over 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And I'm going to put another dot. And I could keep going, count up 2 over 5, down 2 over 5. Or I can draw an approximate line through those two points. Okay. So how's that for a Cliff Notes version of linear equations? Hopefully, most of this is review. If not, this video will be available on my website. But your homework tonight is to work on the Math Excel entitled Linear Equations 1. We're going to work on that today. Hopefully, you've been good for the sub. Hopefully, this video helps you and you feel confident with it. Have a great day. We'll see you tomorrow, or your block day.